A number of bodies have been retrieved from the waters following the flash floods that hit Mbale City on Saturday and Sunday. Today, a section of members of parliament from the sub-regions have come out to express sympathies to their people who lost both life and properties.
It has affected the areas of Namatala. Namatala is an immediate area. We have got Busamaga. The bridge has been cut off. Dokolo, where is our industrial park, has been flooded. We have Onale, the Onale Hill, we have experiencing landslides there.
Yeah, I want to send my condolences to my people of Mbale, Mbale region, and Bulamburi constituency, in particular Kapchora, the whole Elgon zone generally. For those who lost their loved ones, I say sorry.
Addressing a press conference at Parliament, legislators tasked the government to set up temporary evacuation camps in the region, especially in areas prone to disaster.
We should have learned already that we should establish evacuation camps in every district, possibly in disaster-prone areas, districts like Bududa, Namisindwa, Bulamburi Upper, and Sironko Upper, and even Mbale.
MPs also want a comprehensive resettlement plan of the people in the disaster-affected areas, saying the earlier interventions did not yield much as the government fell short of its commitment to construct 900 houses.
The resettlement program, which we began some time back in the last parliament, yes, it is along the way. In Bunambuti and Bulamburi, the projection is 900 resettlement houses. So far, only about 120 have been built.
People who are staying on these hills need to be moved because it's just the start. The rain season is just beginning, and we believe these people are still in danger. And once government does not come to our aid as soon as possible, we believe many more people are going to die.
This time round, Bugisu MPs want the government to respond by compensating affected households with cash to relocate themselves instead of building for them houses that has proven to be difficult.
Compensation would be the best. Personal, one-on-one compensation. If funds are identified, the best way is value someone and then give him money, give her money, as a family.
About 23 bodies. A number of them had come, were visitors from Uvende. I think 9 of them have passed on. And the number is not known. The road infrastructure has been damaged. The homesteads have been damaged. Crops have been destroyed. And the livelihood more or less has been distorted. We are appealing government, our government, that there should be short term, immediate term, medium and long.
Led by John Musira, the Bubulo East legislator, they used the moment to ask for a special ministry in charge of Bugisu affairs to be able to manage the unending disasters.
For a ministry in charge of these Bugisu problems. Problems are solved as they come along. It would be better if we have a ministry for Karamoja, Luwero, Bunyoro, etc. Why can't we have one for Bugisu, especially with these incessant problems all the time, every year you live in fear.
Isaac Katenya, the Bulambuli County MP, is now moving to table a motion before Parliament seeking a creation of a special fund for disaster preparedness on Bugisu sub-region as a way to solve the ever-occurring disasters.
I also want to say that on the floor of Parliament, I want to present a motion concerning a special fund allocated to Elgon zone to address disaster issues, because we are a unique area which needs a special fund. This fund is going to assist us after, before and after the disasters have occurred. They will be in position to put into place the destroyed infrastructures like roads, bridges, schools, health centers, and compensate those people who have lost their crops and those who have lost their lives.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.